According to the Uganda AIDS Commission, over 1.5 million people in Uganda are living with HIV and over 90% are on treatment. Since the introduction of free HIV medication 20 years ago, the main form of treatment has been the oral pills that have to be swallowed every day. Many times, people may forget or find it difficult to swallow the pills, which compromises their health. It is against this background that researchers have come up with once-in-2-months injectable drugs that can be used for both PrEP and treatment. The scientists think these injectable drugs, known as Kabla, will solve the problem of adherence since it will be injected into a person's body and take away the burden of swallowing ARVs every single day. In Uganda, successful studies on the injectable drugs were done in districts of Mityana, Kalangala, Wakiso, and Kasanda.
So I was involved in the oral PrEP studies that looked at serodifferent couples, where one partner has HIV and the other one doesn't. And we showed that if you use antiretroviral drugs, you treat the partner with HIV and reduce their viral load so low that the virus sleeps. And then you give the negative partner PrEP, you can protect them from transmitting HIV, spreading HIV between themselves. So now we found that that works extremely well, but it's really hard, as I have said. People forget, people travel, people get side effects. You traveling with the pills and the rattling in your bag and people asking you what is in your bag. We then decided to develop injectable PrEP. Now this was studied in two large studies that were conducted. The first one was in men who have sex with men and transgender women in North and South America as well as South Africa. And they found that the injection reduced the risk of getting HIV much better than the pill.
According to Dr. Joshua Musinguzi, the director of AIDS control in the Ministry of Health, the government will within 1 month release the policy to guide the use of these injectable drugs starting next financial year.
We are supplementing them with an injectable option. The injectable option, what some people call Kabla or cabotegravir long acting, is an injection that is given every 2 months. And an individual is able to concentrate the medicine in their body, and that they can then be able to prevent themselves from acquiring HIV.
Stakeholders in the fight against HIV believe the injectable drugs will be a game changer in reducing HIV infections, especially in high-risk groups.
The policy now has been reviewed to cater for details of how does somebody give an injection. Who are those people that qualify for an injection? For example, when these policies are reviewed, we shall disseminate them to different health facilities that are offering injectable PrEP. So the healthcare worker based at that facility will be able to open and say, this is how I can assess if somebody is eligible for an injection. When do I give an injection? What are the possible side effects? If those side effects happen, how do I deal with them? So all those highlights are included within the guidelines.
In addition to being effective in prevention, they are also convenient and offer people more privacy and will be helpful, especially to women and children.
What is more important is to know that the drug that we are injecting is safe. That is one, and it is known that it is safe. And two, to know that it is efficacious, effective. That is also has been studied.
It's a drug which we can use to treat those with HIV and those who are not with HIV but don't want to get HIV. So you can use it two ways, with treatment or prevention. But I'll talk in the area where I am. This is an injection which they give you as a person living with HIV and stay off daily medications for 2 months.
If I was found eligible for that, I would also go for it, because first of all, it is worse to go for your next 2-3 months.
Currently, the injectable drug costs $22,000 per year in the United States. This means that donors such as PIPFA and governments will have to increase funding to make them affordable.
Oral PrEP costs about $54 a year. The injection, because it is still new, costs about $22,000 a year. This is pricing for the United States. The drug company has committed to reducing pricing for low and middle income countries like Uganda, but we don't yet know what the pricing will be because it hasn't yet been rolled out. So one of the things that's going to limit the effectiveness of injectable PrEP is cost.
In addition to Cabotegravir, there is ongoing research on a once-in-6-months injectable that is being carried out by IAVI Makere Kalangala site, Makere University, John Hopkins University Research Collaboration in Mitiana, and AMSOL in Masaka. This means people will get only 2 injections in a year, which will eliminate pill burden and increase adherence. And once the injectable PrEP is introduced to high-risk groups such as sex workers, infections will reduce drastically. Report by Sam Wakaka for the news.